Achieved with CryEngine.
Fifth of September, 1862. Dear Diary, today marks the day that I've been in America for a year. And, well, signed up to join the army about 2 months ago. Ever since then, we've been constantly drilling and practicing. There's the occasional punishment here and there from the sergeant. Well, he was there bar run, and he was there in the 7 days, so I suppose it's justified. I'm eager for battle. The boredom's killing me and my comrades. You want to get out of here?
You ask for me, sir?
Yes, Captain. Take a seat.
With all due respect, Colonel, I'd rather remain standing, sir.
Very well, then. This is where you were meant to be, Lord and Captain. In the center of our lines. It's a pretty standard plan, but to put it shortly, your detail will advance on the Confederate center and halt at the hill in front of the rebel fences. There you will take potshots at the Confederates when you can, and wait until the whole Union line pushes up to your position. Then we will do a combined charge on the Confederate positions, and hopefully we will annihilate them.
Understood, sir. Is there anything else?
Well, I want to make sure that your men are in the best condition. So I will have the quartermaster send you extra rations, fresh clothes, and more ammunition. And Captain.
Sir?
No pulling back. It is victory or death. The whole Union Army is depending on us.
I understand, sir.
Dismissed, Captain.
Yes, sir.
Don't let me down, Captain.
Company by far left.
Gather your men and prepare to move out.
Very well,
and hurry
sir.
Up, it's cold out here.
Understood,
yes, sir. Sergeant,
Company
Baker,
A! On me, let's go! What's war like, sir?
It's very deadly and gruesome, gentlemen. I got a story for you both. Care to hear?
Aye, go ahead.
Sir, I got time.
Well, 3 months ago, when I was facing old Yankee McClellan in Glendale, we were ordered by General Walker to move our regiment in a defensive position to halt Heintzelman's Third Corps advance up in some woods. Just then, Colonel Harrison's face turned sour as we spotted 3rd Corps movement advancing toward us. General Walker ordered our regiment to hold fire and wait till the Yankees come to us. I turned to the colonel and I said, "Colonel, those out there are our brothers, and they are about to die by our hands." He responded with, "Captain Hill, we have to do what our duty tells us to do. It is good we are not in favor of our duty, for we would grow too fond of it." I heard the colonel then turn to the regiment and order the first volley. I looked with my glasses and saw tens, if not hundreds, of men fall to the ground. Apparently, they had not seen opposition. As I had seen the Yankees retreat, I thought it was over and we could go home. But General Walker was happy enough with our regiment that he decided for us to advance and chase down the retreating Yanks. We got to the crossroads and spotted a gap in the Federal line. We charged, and all of a sudden everything around me faded to the ground. The Yankees, they had volleyed us. Some of them got up, and that was when I realized I was hit in the hand. Colonel Harrison ordered us to move on out of there, and we took a casualty count. My company had lost 30 men that day. 15 of them were mortally wounded. Me and only 14 others made it out alive, that is.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you for your time, gentlemen.
Grant, let's go.
volley. Full group volley, then charge them.
We have a gap.
Everybody's gonna be firing on this one. Company, rise up.
Where the fuck are they even at?
Rise.
Take aim.
Take aim.
Take aim. Take aim.
Fire. Forward, boys. Forward. Move it, move it, move it. Let's go.
Forward.
Cast under reload. Forward
to the fence.
Melee mode.
Alright, boys, they're falling back. I want three men to a picket. I want three men to a picket.
Fourth, New Jersey.
Into line. Mark. Mark.
Boys,
Pursue! Get over here!
Chase them down! Red's form on my right. Charge!
Oh, here they come.
Charge!
Here they come.
Oh shit.
I need some boots. I need some boots.
Get him!
Dear Diary, 18th of September, 1862. Got a bit of a weird feeling in my stomach. I don't know whether it's shock or dysentery. Probably the former, considering I've only had it since we marched into the battle yesterday. They went in one straight line towards the rebels. Bull Run veterans never prepared us for this one. They just poured into us, and they just cut us down man by man with as vicious a volley as I've ever seen. Well, I saw them, and the next thing I know, I just see the men next to me just falling, dying. Men behind them taking their spots. I feel very lucky to be alive after what we've just been through. My friend Thomas had his legs torn off by a cannonball, but the line just kept moving. We just kept going. No one stopped to help him. It's like a runaway machine. Well, at least he's alive. But probably not for long. Heard he lost a lot of blood. In the medical tent anyway, he's being tended to. Those Bull Run veterans had a bloody point. Well, on the bright side, if you can call it a bright side, they made me a corporal. That's all I got. Pat in the bank, the rank.
Checkmate, Lincolnites!